song until I was almost over, and then I was like, oh wait, that's the End of the Road song.
Let's get friend rings.
Yep.
I don't know if a wedding that ever goes wrong is
going to happen.
Yep. Never happens.
Somebody's got the rest.
Okay. Now don't listen to that stuff. He's not gonna get it. And he says, I'm out.
I'm out.
There he is.
There he is.
And he says, so I told him, what? Okay, then you guys are going to your dad. And I need to discuss this with you. Your dad's your grandmother.
Just a little bit.
Just, oh, okay.
So like you bring time.
Yeah, I know.
Did you bring it before we go?
Yeah.
At least let me take care of the meat for the rest of my family.
Yeah.
Because you always go out and sell cigarettes. You don't need gold pieces. That's 9 cigarettes is worth it.
Well, they're not.
That's what it is, but that's what it's smoking from. You'd be just working right there. Anyway.
It's like a freight train down there.
I'm telling you. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
So, anywho, he says, let me take me to my sister's. I knew there was dying and located in the years
after. Yeah.
So, we walk over to the room, and he says, my sister came in there. Connie Fargo, one of them said, oh, Lavina, you didn't want to name that girl, Mom.
Yeah.
This girl's face went stone.
Why?
So what?
So what?
So anyway.
It's your name.
After that, then his one sister, Diana, who's her
are they coming?
Yeah.
Are they?
My family there. I didn't think about that. So anyways, we get ready to go leave, and Connie turned around and said, Davina was going around tapping people and pointing me at Connie.
You say that, so I'm interviewing with this guy, and he's going to be my boss. His name's Joe Verstrach.
No. Oh.
And he's a 25-year Army vet, but he's a big guy like me, you know. So we're sitting there talking, we hit it off, Mom, this guy and me are two peas in a pod. 10 minutes into it, we're just shooting the breeze, getting to know each other. We forgot the interview. So he said, we have a food reimbursement program. I said, yeah, I'm used to $30 a day. He goes, oh, yes. This place is 25 for lunch and 50 for dinner. I said, man, what do you mean for hot dog today? He goes, whatever you want. I was like, yeah, you made it.
Whatever
you want.
But you're
going
to be locked
up.
Yeah.
Hey, they ain't done nothing, is it?
How are we doing?
Oh, looking for something we lost.
Yeah, that's what I heard. Have you met my mom?
No, I haven't.
Oh, yeah, this is my mom.
Pretty good. How about you?
I'm good. Thank you.
This is Pastor Anita.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
At least my stepdad Andy.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
He taught me how to paint this place.
Yeah, really. He did a good job, didn't he?
He did it in person.
That's all I tell him about it. Hey, I painted the place.
You did good.
Yeah.
I was amazed that he came to church. That's all I went about. And he came where it was, just in a church.
He even came on Christmas Eve.
He did. I was expecting him and
we were going to go to Botkins, but the weather was too bad.
Fall was bad until I started coming out of St. Mary's. I said, Lord, you got to lift this because I can't find this. And then I got my mother off down the road and lifted. And then just enough so I could see where I was going. I get to the church, I was on the drop. So my sister and I got my horse, I took off, got home. Just as I got to the same spot that I was coming in the fall of the fog settled back down. Just enough so I can see the get home and then it's real heavy. He always does. Especially when it rains and I'm driving, I don't like that.
I don't know, we've misplaced it somewhere.
That's all we can say.
Carried to home. We just didn't. We missed it. Yeah, everything's been checked. We know it ain't up here, cause. Last week, so I don't. I'm sure about that.
Thank you. Yeah.